O Lord, hear my voice, for I have called to you. Of you my heart has spoken, seek his face. Hide not your face from me. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Wouldn't it be nice to come into an introit hymn and to start to have some music? I can't for the life of me see why a crowd can sing Abide With Me at a football match, or a handful of Christians can sing something like this. But there we are. Ours is not to reason why. To prepare ourselves to hear God's most holy word and to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sin. Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, and bring you to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Sunday when Dr. Cranmer made more
of the Apostles. One day Peter stood up to speak to the brothers. There are about 120 persons in the congregation. Brothers, the passage of Scripture has had to be fulfilled, in which the Holy Spirit, speaking through David, foretells the fate of Judas, who offered himself as a guide to the men who arrested Jesus, after having been one of our number and actually sharing this ministry with us. In the book of Psalms it says, "Let someone else take his office." We must therefore choose someone who has been with us the whole time that the Lord Jesus was travelling round with us. Someone who was with us right from the time when John was baptising until the day when he was taken up from us. And he can act with us as a witness to his resurrection. Having nominated two candidates, Joseph, known as Barsabbas, whose surname was Justus, and Matthias, they prayed, "Lord, you can read everyone's heart. Show us therefore which of these two you have chosen to take over this ministry, an apostate, which Judas abandoned to go to his proper place." Then they drew lots for them, and as the lot fell to Matthias, he was listed as one of the 12 apostles. The word of the Lord. The response to our psalm this morning is, "The Lord has set his sway in heaven."
The Lord has set his sway in heaven.
My soul, give thanks to the Lord. All my being, bless his holy name. My soul, give thanks to the Lord, and never forget all his blessings.
The Lord has set his sway in heaven.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so strong is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far does he remove our sins.
The Lord has set his sway in heaven.
The Lord has set his sway in heaven, and his kingdom is ruling over all. Give thanks to the Lord, all his angels, mighty in power, fulfilling his word.
The Lord has set his sway in heaven.
Our second reading is from the first letter of St. John. My dear people, since God has loved us so much, we too should love one another. No one has ever seen God, but as long as we love one another, God will live in us, and his love will be complete in us. We can know that we are living in him and he in us, because he lets us share his spirit. We ourselves saw and we testify that the Father sent his Son as Saviour of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in him and he in God. We ourselves have known and put our faith in God's love towards ourselves. God is love, and anyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in him. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I will not leave you orphans, says the Lord. I will come back to you, and your hearts will be full of joy. Alleluia. Those you had given me true to your name. I have watched over them
and not one is lost, except the one who chose to be lost. And this was to fulfil the scriptures. But now I am coming to you, and while still in the world, I say these things to share my joy with them to the full. I passed your word on to them, and the world hated them, because they belong to the world no more than I belong to the world. I am not asking you to remove them from the world, but to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world, and for their sake I consecrate myself, so that they too may be consecrated in truth. And this is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Father, keep those you have given to me true to your name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before we have a look at the Gospel this morning, we must give a nod to poor old Matthias. I always feel sorry for St. Matthias. In the authorised version of the Bible, of course, it simply says, the lot fell on Matthias. And I think, oh, poor old Matthias, buried under that ruddy pile for the rest of his life. We don't know where Matthias came from, but it would seem to be logical that Matthias was one of that group of disciples who were not among the 12, but were close to Jesus. And the Gospels identify them as the 72. Do you remember? The Lord sent out 72 to go into the towns and villages that he was to go to himself. And we think that Matthias was probably one of those 72, as also would have been Barnabas. That puts Matthias into context. It's interesting that it should crop up as this morning's first reading, because we kept St. Matthias' day on Friday. I always find this Sunday more difficult to preach on than Trinity Sunday. I always think of it as like an old age pensioner I am now. I feel as though I'm living in God's waiting room, you know. And this Sunday feels a bit like the waiting room. The ascension has happened, and the 12 or the 11 have gone back to the upper room in Jerusalem, where Jesus commanded them to wait until I send the Comforter, until I send power from on high. And there they are in the upper room, not knowing what to expect. And I imagine that with them would have been Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of the Lord, and probably the other women who stood at the foot of the cross. That little number, still living in fear. The sting hadn't gone out from the Jewish authorities, from the scribes and the Pharisees, or even from the Romans for that matter. We read all about the glory on our part of the resurrection, but never forget the fear that that little bunch must have lived in, not really understanding what the resurrection was about, not knowing what lay ahead, feeling threatened by the civil authorities, So they go back to wait. One of the lessons I think that the pandemic has taught us is to wait. It's brought lots of frustrations. It's caused lots of emotional turmoil. But I hope for the church, her members have learnt to wait upon the Lord. And by being constant in their prayer and their devotion, they've opened their hearts to God and realised that there's more to Christian living than Christian busyness. There are some good things that come out of it all. Jesus, of course, had to return to the Father before he could send Holy Spirit. When Jesus was on the earth, he could only speak to the few people he was with at one moment. In order for that word to spread throughout the world, it needed the power from on high, the power of Holy Spirit. And so he goes back to the Father and leaves the work that he's done. I remember a few years ago being struck by an horrific story in the newspaper of a mother of three children, all of whom were under 12, whom she simply locked in their council flat and went off on her holidays. End of story. That was it. She did nothing to provide for or care for her children while she was away. How much better would it have been if she got a mother and a father, perhaps grandparents of the children, and she could leave strict instructions with them? Mary don't eat Weetabix, and Freddie don't like this, and you must do this and do that and do the other. And then she'd have been accused of not trusting her mother and father, when in actual fact it was out of love for her children. And that's the picture that we've got of Jesus now. He entrusts us to the Father's care. It's very easy to be Jesus-centred in our religion. But Jesus taught us quite clearly to pray, "Our Father." We are entrusted to the Father. And in doing that, in our gospel passage this morning, Jesus tells the Father the things that he wants to do on our behalf. That passage is well worth a quiet 10 minutes on your own to look through it and just consider how it affects your life or how you cooperate with Jesus' will for your life. The personal relationship with the Father and the Son is brought to life and fulfillment and mission by the power of the Holy Spirit. All three members of the Trinity, all three parts of the Godhead, are essential to us. That's why the Pentecostal churches are lopsided. That's why a lot of the modern hymn writing, you know? How many times can you say Jesus, for crying out loud, to two different notes and wag your arms in the air? It's lopsided. All aspects, I've got to be careful not to pinch my Trinity Sunday sermon, all aspects of the Trinity are necessary to a balanced sense of our religion and our belonging. What this plea of Jesus to the Father does for me is to give me a great sense of safety. He entrusts me to the Creator. He entrusts me to the one who knows me better than I know myself. Holy Father, keep those you have given me true to your name, so that they may be one like us. And that harks back to the very act of the Ascension. In going back to heaven, Jesus takes our human nature up to the throne and makes it one with God, from whence it came in the first place. There's a lovely old legend, I think I've told it to you before. When Jesus arrived back at the gate of heaven, God the Father said to him, "Well, you've done a good job, but what have you left behind?" And Jesus said, "I've left 11 men and a few women to carry on the work." "Oh," said the Father, "and what if it fails?" To which the Lord replied, "I have no other plan." And we're still here. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We believe in one Lord, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through the beginning of all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and was born of man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with whom the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, active, and apostolic church. We acknowledge for baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and for the world. And let us thank God for his goodness. Heavenly Father, we pray earnestly on this day for your church in the holy city of Jerusalem, for her newly enthroned Archbishop, and for the unity of all Christians there. We pray for their safety, for peace. Lord, in your mercy. For the church in this land, we pray, Father, as we come out of the pandemic, so we pray to you for the return of the lapsed, for the strengthening of the faith. Help us to learn the lessons of the past year and to trust in your love, to be grateful for your bounty, and to be dependent on your mercy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious.
For Elizabeth, our Queen, for Charles, Prince of Wales, and for all who govern us, for those newly elected to local councils, peace throughout the world. That those who have it in their power to bring about peace may toil tirelessly to that end. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
We thank you for the fellowship that we enjoy here. Pray for the entire family of this parish. We lay before you the needs of our own families. Help us to be understanding in our differences, to be positive in our outlook, to be loving and gentle in our dealings one with another. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For Matt Hancock and for the National Health Service, for all who are in hospital at this time, especially those suffering from the COVID virus, and for all in our high dependency units. For the people of India and their leaders. And for those responsible for keeping this nation safe. Amongst the sick known to us, for Katie and Gary Banks, for Linda, Rita, Maddie, Jim Watson, Monica, Adam Jones, Eddie, Dennis, Bale, John, Kath Edwards, Rosemary, Sheila Beamish, Pauline Benn, Joshua, Bob, Jane Chester, Margaret Rose, Mike Hampson, and Jenny Rothin. For Rosemary Oakley, facing an operation tomorrow. We pray for all agencies of mercy and for those who care for loved ones at home. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who have died in the faith of Christ. For Anne Priest and Don Mills, who died recently. For those whose anniversaries fall at this time, Vanessa Penzer, Margaret Grant, Gwendolyn Bowers, Susan Smith, Marita Hickey, Joanna Parton, Oliver Hayes and Roger Brown, our own families, benefactors and friends. May they rest in peace and rise in glory, and may we in our turn share with them in the glory of your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. In a moment of silence, we bring our private prayers to the throne of grace. These and all of our prayers to the intercession of the Mother of the Lord, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord, you know our needs before we ask. Fulfill our prayers according to your will, and bring us at the last to your eternal kingdom, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We are the body of Christ. By one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. We make our prayer through Christ the Lord. Amen. Amen. Pray, beloved, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the glory of his church.
The Lord be with you. So, Father, we bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, after supper, he took the again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all people so that sins may be forgiven. Do this memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is God.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, calling to mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favour on your church's offering, and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by his body and blood, may be filled with his Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an everlasting gift to you, and enable us to share in the inheritance of your saints, with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the Apostles, with St. Matthias, with St. Paul and all the martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for help. Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Michael, our diocesan, Clive, our area bishop, Jonathan, our visitor, with the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Father, hear the prayers of the family who've gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory, through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many,
we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Thank you. Father, I pray that they may be one, as we also are one. Alleluia. Keep you all in eternal life. Amen. us pray. Hear us, O God, our Saviour, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church that which has already come to pass in Christ her head, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia.